Over the years, science has made great strides in many areas. Yet we have failed to act on our most valuable asset, time. There are no methods to increase the hours in a day. At least, I believe so. Do you know any? But there are technologies that support us in optimizing it. Automation is one of them. The more tasks and processes we can make autonomous, the more time we can devote to actions that improve business performance. But what do we need to know about automation? Keep watching the video to discover some key insights. Ready? Let's dive in. First of all, in the field of automation, it's useful to understand what changes when we talk about cognitive automation and deterministic automation. Actually, there's no real difference. In fact, we can say that intelligent process automation, IPA, is the convergence of two technologies, robotic process automation, RPA, and artificial intelligence. The contribution of AI is precisely to go beyond deterministic software programming and adapt the program based on new data processed from a dataset chosen as the source of machine training. Let's take an example. Suppose you need software that will classify data in the same columns as a standard spreadsheet and enter the instructions first. In that case, deterministic automation will be enough for you to repeat the process with each request. If, on the other hand, you need to classify information that comes to you via email, whose text is constantly changing, you need software that goes beyond mere classification and can read and interpret the content. So, while in the former case you will only need RPA, you will need IPA in the latter. Are you already adopting RPA or IPA in your company? Feel free to comment below, and if you enjoy the video, well, why not put a like as well? Although there is no doubt that automation facilitates the work of human resources, optimizes processes, and improves performance in the short and long term, not all companies choose a full implementation. It is common, more or less unknowingly, to use software that has automation only in particular areas. But what are the aspects to consider before making any kind of choice? We are going to analyze them in the following chapter. Number 1. Interconnected processes. The logic of silos falls away. Department divisions are separations that are useful from an organizational point of view to define boundaries or assign activities, but not functional from an operational point of view. Today's activities are increasingly interconnected and processes require sharing and smooth passage of information. We cannot imagine a human resources department that does not interact crosswise with all departments for which it will have to hire new people, nor a marketing department that is only superficially familiar with the product or service which is the subject of an entire campaign. Yet, there's not always sufficient time for information sharing, and more importantly, not all processes are structured to cross organizational boundaries. And here, automation becomes an avenue that facilitates data transition. Through summary dashboards, automation allows all employees to update and show data in real time during meetings. Number 2. Barriers to the adoption of automation. When it comes to new technologies or innovations which are spreading and involve heavy investment, there are two main barriers: the high cost to be incurred, especially if the revenues are not immediate, and a lack of experts in the company who know how to implement the technology and optimize it in a short time. Automation is no exception in that. It requires skilled figures who cannot be trained in a short time and who, beyond the specific profession, can sense the potential and the sectors that could benefit the most. Example: if you want to automate the subscription management of a service, there is a software already programmed that would be sufficient to rely on. But if the service your company provides has exceptions, a pre-programmed program would not suffice. especially if the data used for programming changes all the time. Here is where an expert programmer is needed, who can not only handle the variations, but also shape the program based on the evolutions of the service. If you don't have experts in the company, the costs rise and add to the initial investment that will need more time to pay back. It's good to remember that human resources in the IT department perform various day-to-day activities already broken in, and the entry of automation, especially during the initial phase, requires time to devote that often cannot be found. In addition, the costs devoted to the IT department are not many and often run out with the purchase of technologies. Finally, let's not forget that defining a well-structured strategy takes time and expertise. Just as indispensable is also a correct choice of the dataset to be used to program automation and worrying about the constant updating of data. Number 3. How to cope with change and resources. After ensuring you have the right skills and budget to implement automation, you need to involve most of the operational resources that will participate in the change. Therefore, you will be faced with questions such as, how do I do training if I don't have time? If I have difficulties with the new processes, can I go back? If the program does these activities, what do I do? Are we sure we know the right strategies? Doubts during a change are psychological and sometimes even functional, but you must be prepared to give comprehensive and focused answers. This brings you to the next suggestion. Number 4. Getting people to understand the potential of automation. The first step when introducing innovation is to show what the change will be. It must be explained to employees that they won't lose their duties, but simply receive support that will enable them to devote themselves to more complex and fulfilling activities. Only in this way can obstructive actions to implementation be avoided. Instead, users of the software or services will need to be shown, in addition to the new methodologies, how the technology offers quick and effective solutions, and to illustrate what the benefits of automation are, which may not be clear at first. Let's not forget to evaluate the training time of the resources working in the processes involved. With them, you will have to share the strategy and long-term goals to show practically how automation optimizes processes and makes the work of resources more efficient. Number 5. How automation fits into flows and processes. The only way to ensure customized automation based on business needs is to incorporate change into business process management. BPM outlaws optimizing workflows and processes, reducing costs, efficiently allocating resources, and improving scalability. This will highlight the flows where automation will make a difference. Indeed, you cannot automate effectively unless you thoroughly understand your processes and the effects they generate in the organization. It also has been seen that the sectors which benefit most from automation are logistics, finance, and the human resources department. This is because they have structured processes that are repeated with some frequency, such as sending and classifying invoices, managing orders, and searching for resources based on skills and relevant CVs. RPA, and especially advanced automation in which artificial intelligence also plays its part, is not only expressing its potential in already active activities, but is also proving useful in research and development departments and predictive activities whose data analysis enables more accurate decision making. And by the way, if you would like to discover more about RPA, I suggest you give a glimpse to my video right here in the corner, which is just focused on that. Lastly, we can summarize the key points analyzed in this video through the following infographic, which is about 10 things you need to know about automation. Thank you. watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it as the last video of the year 2022. And if it is so, feel free to subscribe to my YouTube channel as more content will come shortly. Plus, click on the bell to make sure you receive a direct notification whenever I publish a new video. See you in the next year, in 2023. Ciao!